You can't clear out your inbox, can you? Yeah, I know. I've seen it. It's all over the place. People are out here with inboxes that look just like this that are struggling to reach that sweet, sweet inbox zero. And for me, I'm somebody who knows exactly what it's like to go through this. There are a lot of really great ways to clear out your inbox on a consistent basis that people just simply don't do. I had to deal with it at work a couple of weeks ago, and I taught someone how to really limit the way that this can happen. And I'm going to show you exactly how to do that for yourself in this video. So first and foremost, I'm going to talk about the most basic of all things, which is unsubscribing from emails. And unsubscribing from emails is that first step where you'll essentially get something like a promotion from a product that you've signed up for and then stopped using, and then you keep getting emails for it. Gmail has done a great job of actually adding this unsubscribe feature. So you can simply click on it and press unsubscribe. But what I really want you to do is the next step, which I think is even more important. If you go to the email itself, like the person that sent the email, and then press the filter button here, you can find any email from them. And what you can do is you can actually create a filter for that, or you can just search for it. So say I search for all the emails from this person. I could then click on them, mark them as read, and then archive them. Or if I know that I'm gonna keep getting the spam because for some reason things come through and I just don't really wanna deal with these anymore, what I can do is I can press a search again and press create filter, click apply to 25 matching conversations, and then select what I want to apply it to and do mark as read and skip the inbox, create the filter, and bingo. You'll notice that in a moment, these are simply going to be added to the archive. So if I do Taylor again, you'll see that these are archived because they have the ability to move into the inbox now. All right, so we can do this with pretty much everything we see here. All we have to do is go through for a couple minutes, grab this, filter messages like these, create filter, skip the inbox, mark as read, apply to the old ones, rinse and repeat. Now there's gonna be some ones that are pretty long and pretty annoying. So I would definitely recommend that you, for those, do a little bit of a double check, make sure it's the right things. Like for example, I end up having a lot of invoices that come to this email. So what I want to do is I actually want to use service at PayPal as an opportunity to do something else. I'm going to add a label over here for something like invoices. And anytime I get an invoice that comes into this account, I want to filter messages like these from service at PayPal. And you'll see they're pretty much all invoices. It's really frustrating. So all I need to do is press create filter, mark it as read, and then I'm going to add the label to it, invoices. And then I'm gonna apply it to 65 conversations, press create filter. And then in a moment, my inbox will go from 1,073 down to close to a little over 1,000. Oh, look at that, applied, bingo. So now anytime I have new ones too, it's gonna prevent this as well. Using that rule filter is going to prevent more of that same clutter from coming in, and unsubscribing and then following the step afterwards is gonna be outstanding for you. So I definitely recommend that you try out that part of the system. The second thing I do to keep my inbox clear is pretty simple. If I go to my personal or business email, I have always had like a fair amount of reminders that end up coming up in my email and what I used to default to and what I've tried to showcase here. So I have some things here that are essentially a part of what I usually have to deal with in my inbox to clear things out. I have this Lyric Opera and these movie tickets that I purchased and end up like waiting until the event day or whatever in order to have this in my inbox. And that's, I guess, fine, but that usually ends up leading to like five things of clutter if I'm not careful about it. And then I'm like, wait a second, what am I doing? Why is it in my email? Do I have emails? And the best thing I would do afterwards is essentially, sure, you know that there is this Lyric Opera order confirmation. You know that there are tickets right here. So all that I would do is simply do the following. I know I'm going to the Lyric Opera on Sunday. In order to make any tickets or anything like that really work, all you have to do is add an action item on that day in your task management system, and then add any files or hyperlinks to it. And then also link that email to the system as well. If you use products like TickTick, it's actually really easy. You can simply take one of these and turn them into a task. You can also set up automations to make them into a task very easily with something like Notion, or you can mark them as a label like tasks, for example, and then you can name it tasks inbox. I guess you can't name it tasks, sorry. Or you can name it to-do list, whichever you'd like. To-do list may make more sense, to be fair. And then I would simply right click on them and label them as your to-do list. And after I label all of them as my to-do list, and I have them, they're going to be still unread. See, obviously I have my order confirmation. That's cool. What I would do is I would essentially take all the information, right? I can open the email in a new tab, copy the link, and then make a task for Sunday when I go to the Lyric Opera. Just say Lyric Opera tickets, and I'm going to just add some notes and add the tickets, and that's it. That's it. Like, that's all I really need to do. So if I do this, like, order confirmation, paste the link to the email. Okay. Doesn't really need to be in my inbox anymore. Okay. What we got here? Link you Lyric Opera ticket purchase. Cool. Okay. So let's just open up this guy again. Just grab the email, and I'm going to say Lyric Opera tickets. And for my own sanity, I'm going to just download these, call them Lyric Opera tickets, drag them onto my Notion or whatever task management system I'd have. Right. Cool. And then the same thing here. Like, I have tickets here today. I'm going to go watch Joker Part 2, Electric Boogaloo. I'm going to make another one. I'm going to move that Lyric Opera task to the day it is. I'm going to open this up and go, okay, watch Joker 2. And if you name them things that you actually care about and remember, you're going to actually have a better time after I label this and put it as tickets, hyperlink it. Yeah, you're gonna have a better time keeping track of what you actually did rather than looking in your Gmail inbox. It's kind of not the best experience. So simply now when I open up my phone, I just have to go to the link to the email and it's in my inbox and I can just simply finish out the day with a clear inbox because this guy is no longer here. And if you do have automations and stuff, you can add a label to it and then it would simply like go into your task to-do list, which I'm gonna show you how that would look really quickly by building out an automation for it. So I'm just setting up a automation to where when an inbox or a item in my inbox gets labeled as to-do list and test this trigger, it would then make a specific email task inside of Notion. I just create a database item and this can be done with two steps on any platform. I added the database here, and then I'm just gonna make the task name, the subject, the email. I'll have the priority go into my little like backlog of tasks. And I'm gonna make the content of it actually be a couple things. I'm gonna make it the body HTML, and I'm gonna put at the top of it a hyperlink to the email. All right, so let's try it out. All right, so this is your AMC order, hyperlinks to the email, cool. And bingo, when I open the link, it brings me to Joker Folie à deux. And I can change the name of that task to simply be Joker 2 tickets. And if I wanted to in the first place, I could have had this link just be the name of the email and just call it Joker 2 tickets. And then some of the plain text is within here too for context if I want to look at it. But that's pretty much all I need to do in order to clear out my inbox. If I simply take the tasks off my plate and learn how to do some very, very basic things regarding rules and unsubscribing, my inbox can be cleared out just like yours can. With that being said, thank you for trying out all of these tips and tricks for how to keep your inbox at zero. And with that being said, I will see you in the next one.